We're so well organized. It's great. In the middle of the night, you have to pee really bad. Oh, I'm getting out of my bunk. Look at this. See here? There's my shoes in a drawer. Out of your way.
Oh, I thought we were going to get a shoe rack.
Well, we haven't yet, so I'm trying to do a little favor for everyone.
I didn't get that memo.
I think that because we all went to high school together and we've known each other for such a freaking long time that we're able to tolerate each other's nuisances, tolerate things that would cause a lot of bands to want to not be on the road anymore. We've been dealing with each other for such a long time that we know exactly where to go and when to go and how to deal with each other, both on a positive and negative level. We know how to handle each other. We're like brothers. So we are able to just keep touring. I mean, it's easy for us. I would do all of this again. Travel back in
time with you to where this all began. We're turning down White Avenue, which is where I turn down every morning to go to high school. This is where the last drags of the cigarette were coming out before I had to go to class. It's a performing arts high school. It's a magnet school. This is where Yellow Card was formed, was in this school. High school was pretty rad for all of us. It was a real creative environment.
Hi, this is Pete, and you're watching Yellow Card TV. We're here with Sean Mackin, the fiddle player for Yellow Card.
Violin.
Whatever.
Watching the video, and I'm like, hey, there's a guy with a violin. That's awesome. I want to play violin.
In a band, dude?
Yeah. In a punk band, of all things.
You know, the number one most asked question, other than what's the name of the band mean, is how'd you get a violin in your band? And it's because we went to a school like this. You had a guy who was in the orchestra playing violin, which at a regular high school would get, you know, like picked on and beat up every day. But at our school, he played violin during the day and then went out and partied with us at night. So it was like we had a good friend who did something unique, you know, musically. And when he started jamming with the band, it just worked out.
I think you sort of start something like here. You
know. So, this is my violin. This is a family heirloom.
This is the close-up. Maybe a Stradivarius one day, but I don't think I deserve a Stradivarius, so we'll just keep practicing. Keep practicing.
One summer, I put the guitar down for a couple months and sat down at the piano and tried to figure out how that worked. And through that, I learned a lot of like theory stuff, because I actually learned what the notes were and what made up what chords or whatever.
Progression.
And now I'm just playing bass. I'm just a bass player.
You sing a little.
Try to sing a little.
He sings really high.
As little as possible.
He's got the range in the band. He's got the high C in there.
Sometimes, on good days.
This is my kit. My baby, her name is Animal.
He was a better drummer than all of my other friends at that age that were drummers. I could just tell. You know, it was just obvious. Pure talent.
Started playing professionally at the age of 5 with my dad's band, the Laundry New Parsons Ensemble. We played a lot of jazz clubs.
Craziest drummer I ever did meet. Some may write with him, some may write at all.
Hey, watch this.
I don't think we'd be a band if it wasn't for this guy right here.
So I would say my last day job before Yellow Card became able to pay the bills was I was selling herbal products, it was incoming sales, so people would call and I would pick up the phone, and it was for herbal breast enhancers and herbal Viagra and like stuff that removed your veins and stuff. And I would, you know, it would be like middle-aged women calling, and I would answer the phone and try to sell them these like $300 pills that would make their breasts go from a size A to size B or whatever. It's really interesting. But that's my last job before Yellow Card made it.
First time I heard myself on the radio, I thought it was cool. I think we were all pretty startled by it, you know, pretty much, you know, just all happy because we'd been waiting for a long time to be on the radio because we came from an independent side where we didn't have radio, we didn't have TV, hell, we didn't even have records put out in the stores.
I think with the new record, we didn't plan too much on a theme, but there kind of ended up being one, and it kind of became the story of our journey from Florida to California and everything in between. All the stuff we had to deal with to get where we are is definitely written about on the record. It's got kind of a positive vibe to it because we kind of took nothing and turned it into something.
This is good.
Where
are you guys filming?
What?
Where are you guys filming?
As for DVD.
No, really. Like, who are you? Like, what are you guys doing?
We play in a band called Yellow Card, and we're on the Warped
Tour.
No
way. I don't believe you. Are you lying to me?
That's why I was like messing with you.
No, are you guys serious? Because that's my favorite band.
You don't even know who we got.
Okay, yeah, I don't believe you. Okay, sing me a line. Sing me a line from Cigarette. That's like my favorite Yellow Card song. Come on. Oh my god. Oh my god. I don't believe you. Come on, just give me some proof.
Here you go.
What? Let me see the back.
Here you go.
Let me see it. Yeah, right. I'm keeping this.
What a f***ing rock star.
Dude, I'm totally surveying, man. This has nothing to do with Rockstar.
Like, seriously, I've got your CDs in my car. Like, this is unreal. No, they're all burned CDs.
The last 6 months have been strange.
Strange?
To say the least.
Strange good or strange bad?
It's a whole lot of both. It's not bad, but it's like...
No, it's humbling, weird. And at the same time, you're like, you feel like it's, yeah, it can
it's
mix
just
you
not,
up in the head.
You know what I mean? Like, because like you said, we're just kids from Jacksonville.
This is my brother from the other side.
We met in ninth grade of high school.
Ryan, who's our singer now, joined the band. From there, we decided to move to California and just tour.
We wanted to be where the music was being made. We wanted to be able to play way more shows than we were able to in Florida.
We got some good kids down here in Southern California. Let's play some rock and roll music.
And then, so we kept going, touring, and the underground buzz and the hype picked up. And in about April of 2002, signed with Capitol.
Capitol came to sweep you.
Yeah, they were just, well, we felt most comfortable with them. Like, they let us be ourselves. They didn't want to stir it up too much.
It's a chance of a lifetime. It only comes once. It's never going to happen again. So we're just trying to work as hard as we can and do what we know how to do and play a little music, you know?
Hi, I'm Longinu, and I'm here to play the drums. These are my drums, and I'm here to be on video, see? Like, those people up there are filming me, so it's gonna be fun.
Roll playback, here we go!
Way, way, away from here I'll be.
Did I watch MTV growing up? I watched MTV growing up.
Oh, God.
It's like 5 a.m. We're gonna make a video today. This is what you do. You get up at 5 o'clock in the morning.